गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज द एनुअल पोर्शन ऑफ क्लास 9th. इन दैट वी आर हैविंग द टू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर 3 एंड चैप्टर 4. सो चैप्टर 3, दैट इज एटम्स एंड मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड चैप्टर फोर दैट इज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम. सो आई विल टीच यू द फर्स्ट अबाउट द एटम एंड देन ओनली आई कैन टीच यू द एटम्स एंड मॉलिक्यूल्स. Okay, therefore we'll study about the structure of atom first and then it will easier to understand about the atoms and molecules. But the sum of the part, introductory part is given in chapter 3 only. So I will start from chapter 3. Some points I will take from the chapter 3. But I will complete first the chapter 4. So in copy you will write down the heading chapter 4. And that is structure of atom. Okay. So chapter 4 you will write. But these topic which I am going to teach, they are from chapter 3. Because they are the introductory part about the atoms. So we will write down the chapter 4. That is structure of atom. Now, we'll study about some introductory part of atom, how the word atom came into the existence. Now, around 500 BC, Indian and Greek philosopher wonder about how the matter is formed, how the padarth, in Hindi matter is known as padarth, so how the padarth is formed. So the Indian philosopher, now what is the difference between philosopher and scientist? Philosopher, they only think about the phenomena. They just give their idea or they can think beyond the reality. But the scientist, they think also and they also give whether the given concept is correct or not. They give the experimental proof for the statement. So whatever the philosopher they have said, they don't have any experimental proof, only they are giving the statement. Okay, so this is the difference between philosopher and scientist. Philosopher, they only give their statement, they don't have any experimental proof. But scientists give their statement and also they have their experimental proof. Now, around 500 BC, Indian philosopher, Indian philosopher Maharishi Kanad. Indian philosopher Maharishi Kanad, or in Hindi it is known as Kanad. Maharishi Kanad said that if we go on dividing the matter into smaller and smaller particle, one stage will come when we cannot divide the matter. And this smallest particle is known as Parmanu. He said that if we go on dividing the matter into smaller and smaller particle, then the stage will come when we cannot further this small particle, and this smallest particle is known as Parmanu. So the word Parmanu was given by Indian philosopher Maharishi Kanar. This is the smallest particle of matter, smallest particle of Padarth, which is known as Parmanu. Next, the Greek philosopher, another Indian philosopher, that is Pakuda Katyayam. This is also the Indian philosopher Pakuda Katyayam. He said just opposite of Maharishi Kanal. What he said that if that matter exists in combined form. And various combination of particles give different kind of matter. So according to Pakuda Katyayam, that matter exists in combined form. Combined form means the particles combined to give matter. Matter exists in combined form and various combination of particles give different forms of matter. We have studied in case of first chapter, solid, liquid and gas. The particles, they have the different arrangement, and this different arrangement of particle give rise to the solid, liquid and gas. So the different forms of matter arise due to the variation in the arrangement of particles of matter. Now the Greek philosopher at the same time, they also have given their philosophy. So the Greek philosophers, that is Democritus and Leucippus, they also said that if we go on dividing the matter into smaller and smaller particle, a stage will come when further division is not possible, and they call this smallest particle as atom. So the word atom was given by Democritus and Leucippus. And atom is a Greek word, and this word means, what does this word mean? That is indivisible particles. Atom is a Greek word which means indivisible particles. So, we have seen how the word atom came into existence. Now, all these philosophical consideration does not have any experimental proof. At the end, you will write down one line that all these philosophical consideration or thinking, all these philosophical consideration did not have any experimental proof. Did not have any experimental experimental proof. So the word atom that is given by Greek philosopher Democritus and Leucippus. Now at the end of the 18th century, scientists recognized the difference between element and compound. Some of the elements were discovered and these elements were occurring in the form of compound. So they have recognized the difference between element and compound. Now how these elements combine to form compound? They are governed by certain laws, and these laws are known as laws of chemical combination. And these laws of chemical combination, they have the experimental proof also. So at the end of the 18th century, the scientists, they want to prove that how the atom exists into the nature, and that is in the combined state the atom exists. And to combine, they have to follow certain rules, they have to follow certain laws, and these laws are known as laws of chemical combination. Laws of chemical combination. So laws of chemical combination, what are these laws? These laws govern or tells the rule how the elements combine to form compound. So here you will write one statement: elements combine to form compound, is governed by following laws. Total 5 laws are there, but in class 9 you will study only the 2 laws. The 2 laws are given in NCERT, that only you will study. But in actual there are total 5 laws. Rest 3 law you will study in class 11th. Now first is the law of conservation of mass. Law of conservation of mass. And second is law of constant proportion. Law of constant or law of definite proportion. Law of definite or constant proportion. Only these two laws we have to study in class 9th, and rest 3 laws you will study in class 11th. Okay. Now the first law, that is law of conservation of mass. Now what do we mean by conserve? Conserve, that is to remain as it is. In lower classes you have also studied conservation of energy, that is the energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, it is transformed from one form to another. Similarly, this is also the law of conservation of mass, that mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. And it was given by scientist Antony Lavoisier. It was given by Antony Lavoisier. Name of the scientist, Antony Lavoisier. And it states that mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in all chemical reactions. This is the statement of law of conservation of mass, that mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in all chemical reaction or in a chemical reaction. In a chemical, kar lo. Write down in a chemical reaction. We are talking about particular reaction. So in a chemical reaction. So this is the statement of law of conservation of mass. And this law is experimentally proved also. He done the experiment, and with the help of experiment he has proved the law. How he has done the experiment? In the experiment, what he has taken? He has taken a glass tube. It is a glass tube, S-shaped glass tube, and from the top it is sealed. And this tube is known as Landolt's tube, L-A-N-D-O-L-T-S. Landolt's tube. In the Landolt's tube, he has taken the two solution, that is silver nitrate solution. This is silver nitrate solution and barium chloride solution. Then he has weighed this apparatus on the weighing balance. Weighing balance pe isne iska weight measure kar liya. After measuring the weight, again what he did, he mixed both the solution. He tilted the tube aise tilt kar denge, both the solution will get mixed and there will be chemical reaction. And what will form? The new product is formed. So the silver nitrate that combined with barium chloride to give silver chloride, AgCl plus sodium, that is barium nitrate, silver chloride and barium nitrate. Silver chloride and barium nitrate. Here you can write down 2 just to balance the reaction. Okay. Now what you observe, the new product is formed, that is silver chloride and barium nitrate is formed after the reaction. Now again, after mixing the solution, again he had weighed the tube. And what he observed, the weight was same. Suppose before the experiment, before mixing the solution, suppose the weight was 100 gram. And after mixing the solution, again he weighed and it is 100 gram only. So the total weight, the total mass remain conserved. And what should be the criteria? That chemical reaction should be carried out in a closed container. The chemical reaction should be carried out in a closed container. Why? Because if any vapors come out or if any gas come out and it will go out of the apparatus, then the weight will not be same. The weight will reduce. So to prove that law of conservation of mass, the chemical reaction should be carried out in a closed container. Now after the experiment, we can write down one more statement for the law of conservation of mass, that is it states that total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. So again, one more statement for the law you can write down. It states that in a chemical reaction, total mass of reactant or total mass of product, you write down first, total mass of product is always equal to total mass of reactants. Total mass of reactants. So one more statement you can write down for the law of conservation of mass. It states that total mass of products is equal to total mass of reactants. Now based on these law, few questions are also there. You have to solve the numerical based on these law. Okay, so we'll solve few questions on the base on law of conservation of mass. Now we'll solve one numerical based on law of conservation of mass. Suppose the question is calculate amount of carbon dioxide gas formed. Calculate amount of carbon dioxide gas formed when 12 gram of carbon is burnt with 32 gram of oxygen. When 12 gram of carbon is burnt with 32 gram of oxygen. So this is the question. You have to calculate the amount of CO2 formed when 12 gram of carbon is burnt with 32 gram of oxygen. So how you solve it? Solution, you will write down according, first you will write down the reaction, that is carbon plus oxygen give carbon dioxide. Carbon plus oxygen will give carbon dioxide. And according to law of conservation of mass, mass of reactants is equal to mass of products. Now what is the mass of reactant? Here 12 gram of carbon is given plus 32 gram of oxygen, and you have to find out the amount of carbon dioxide, so you can write here x. So what will be the value of x? X is equal to 44 gram, because this equal to this, so the value of x will be 44 gram. So amount of carbon dioxide formed, that will be 44 gram. Thank you.